To do this, I'll first add a new variable. I'll call it friends2 for now. Now in the constructor, I need to initialize friends2. And there's that error. I needed to import it. So far, so good. Now I'll fix addFriend. I'll add the friend to both of the lists that I'm keeping track of right now. I tried to add the whole friend instead of just the name. Much better. Let's see if the tests are still passing. Person tester. Looks like things are matching, so I'll go to getFriends. Instead of using friends, I want to use friends2. But friends2 is an array list, so I need to get a string representation of it. But toString returns brackets around what I want. So I'll need to remove the brackets using substring. I'll put it in a variable, and now I'll return substring, starting with the second character and stopping before the last character. Let's see if the tests still pass. Looks like everything is still matching, except that there's a trailing comma right here. But that's the getFriend method, so I'll come back to that. And now for the especially satisfying one. I'll get to delete all of this code and replace it with one line. I'll get the element of the array list at friendIndex, and now everything is actually matching what we wanted it to. But I need to clean up my extra unused variables. I still have this private string friends, and I'm not using it anywhere. Or at least I shouldn't be. So I'll delete it there, and here, and here, and I think that's all of it. But now friends2 has a sort of silly name. So I just want to change friends2 to be friends. So I'll use findReplace and replace all of the occurrences. Creating an extra variable might have looked like extra work. And if you didn't do all of that, that's fine. I did it to show you how you might approach a much larger refactoring. Sometimes when you're working on a very big refactoring, it's good to make sure that everything still works at each intermediate stage. You'll learn more about that if you take a job as a software engineer.